am Shiva, faculty of physics. In this session, we are going to discuss about one important topic called as force on dielectric slab when the plates of capacitor are maintained at constant charge. Okay. So first of all, consider one parallel plate capacitor. This parallel plate capacitor initially uncharged. These are the plates of capacitor. This each and every plate having an area A and length L. Initially, this capacitor is uncharged, nothing but no charge on the plates of capacitor. So previously, here also charge 0, here also charge 0. Later, we are connecting this parallel plate capacitor with battery. So this capacitor now start to charge until the potential difference across the plates of capacitor is equal to the applied potential. Say this plate which is connected to the positive terminal charged positively and the plate connected to the negative terminal charged negatively. So after the charging, we are assuming this plate is charged to Q, this plate is charged to minus Q, totally our capacitor now charged to Q. Now what we can do? So here remove this battery. So this is battery now. So remove this battery. Okay. So after removing this battery, this circuit now looks like just only we are having one capacitor. Now assume one dielectric slab. So this is what we are seeing now. This is dielectric slab. This dielectric slab having some dielectric constant K. This dielectric slab now you are introducing between the plates of capacitor. So this capacitor plates are charged to Q. At the time of introducing this dielectric slab between the plates of capacitor, still the charge of the plates of capacitor is constant. At some instant, x length of the dielectric is introduced between the plates of capacitor. Say the force acting on this dielectric, now it will become F. So already we know why the force F will act on the dielectric. This F acting on the dielectric is exerted by the free charges of the plates of the capacitor. Now this is the force acting on the dielectric slab when the capacitor plates are maintained at constant charge. So now in this case, what is the value of this force? What is the value of this force? What is the nature of this force? This force is constant or variable. That force magnitude now we are interested here to calculate. Okay. Now clearly observe the system a little bit. Even this is single capacitor of capacitance C, but indirectly we are seeing now this is the system of two capacitors. One is C1, another one C2. C1 now we can visualize, C1 is the capacitor. This is filled with air having the length L minus X. C2 is also one more capacitor having the length X. Okay, so two capacitors. One capacitor filled with air of length L minus X. Another capacitor filled with dielectric of length X. Nothing but this system is equal to the two capacitor system. One is filled with air having the capacitor C1. Another one filled with dielectric having the capacitor C2. Nothing but this is C1, this is C2. So why here we are assuming these capacitors are parallel? From the theory of electrostatics, we know that surface of the conductor acts as equipotential surface. That's why this plate having some potential that is equal at each and every point. This plate also having some potential that is same at each and every point. But this plate now lying at higher potential, this plate is lying at lower potential. This higher potential and lower potential same for capacitance C1 and capacitance of capacitor C2 is is also same. That's why the potential difference across the capacitor C1 as well as the potential difference across the capacitor C2 is same. That's why here what we can conclude, C1, C2 is parallelly connected. Okay. So now, in order to calculate the force acting on the parallel plate capacitor, as we know, since F is conservative force, the force acting on the dielectric we can calculate with the help of this formula, that is F is equal to minus du by dx, where u is the electrostatic potential energy stored between the plates of parallel plate capacitor. Okay, so what is the formula for u? Clearly you are seeing, for our parallel plate capacitor charge is constant, but capacitance is variable. Why the capacitance is variable? Whenever the dielectric length of the dielectric inside the capacitor is increases, automatically the value of C2 changes. Whenever the value of C2 changes, C1 also changes. Finally, the capacitance also changes. Nothing but we'll expect C is the variable. That is, the capacitance of these two parallel plate capacitors is variable, but charge is constant. That's why here what we can say, in order to calculate the electrostatic potential energy, we'll use this formula, u is equal to q square by 2c. Okay, so now substitute this formula here, what we can write, f is equal to minus d by dx of, substitute the value of u here, q square by 2c. Okay, so again minus here q constant, 2 also constant, take that one out, minus q square by 2 into d by dx of 1 by c. Okay, so now calculate the equal capacitance. Okay, since these two plates are parallelly connected, so this is at plus V, this is at, suppose I am saying 0. Now what is C here? C is equal to C1 plus C2. So what is C1? Formula, epsilon naught A by D. So since this gap is filled with A of dielectric constant 1, now we can write epsilon naught area. So what is the area? This is the L minus X. Again now plate length also, then we have L in 3D. That's why here what we can write, L minus X into L by D. Okay, plus, so for dielectric slab formula are there, K epsilon naught A by D. So K epsilon naught. So again, what is the area? X length we are seeing in L also, length of the dielectric. That's why here what we can write, X indicates length of the dielectric. L again, that plate breadth. Here we are assuming square plate. Na? This plate is what type of plate you are assuming? This is square plate. Square plate, nothing but length also L only, breadth also L only. That's why here what we can write now, K epsilon naught XL by, what is the separation? Let the separation now between the plates is D. Okay, so here also it will become D. So here also it will become D. So that's why here we can write as D. Okay, what is C now here? C is equal to epsilon naught L by D, term common, na? Take it out. Epsilon naught L by D, L minus X plus KX. Okay, it will become epsilon naught L by D, L plus K minus 1 into X. So this capacitance you are seeing as the function of X. When X changes, C also changes. Now what we can write here, substitute this value of C here, what we can write now? U is equal to minus Q square by 2 d by dx of reciprocal of this one. Okay, so this is C, but then you are seeing 1 by C, reverse C, that is the reciprocal of C. We can write as d by epsilon naught into L into L plus k minus 1 into x. Okay. Again, this d distance between the two plates, that is also constant. Epsilon naught constant. L nothing but plate length. That is also constant. Take this term entirely outside. Now what we can write here? Minus q square d by 2 epsilon naught into L into d by dx of L plus k minus 1 into x whole power minus 1. Okay, so in order to calculate this one, use this expression already from the differential calculus. We know na d by dx of f of x whole power n is equal to n into f of x whole power n minus 1 into d by dx of f of x. So use this expression here. Now what we can write? Minus q square d by 2 epsilon naught into L. Now apply. This is f of x for us. So use this formula. Here what is the value of n? N value of minus 1 for us. So minus 1 into L plus k minus 1 into x whole power minus 2. Again d by dx of L plus k minus 1 into x. So it will become, so minus minus plus na. Now what we can write? Q square d by 2 epsilon naught L plus k minus 1 into x whole square. So d by dx of L, d by dx of L 0, why L constant? That's why d by dx of L is 0. D by dx of k minus 1 into x. K minus 1 also constant. Na? Take that k minus 1 is outside. Again, d by dx of x here will become 1. That's why here what we can write? K minus 1. Now finally, this expression will become for us. F net is equal to. This is. Here we are writing. This is u, na, so this is not u. F for us. Okay, this is F. So this is the value of F now we got here. Now finally here what we can write? F is equal to Q square D into K minus 1 divided by 2 epsilon naught into L plus K minus 1 into X whole square. Okay, so this is the expression for the force acting on the dielectric slab between the plates of capacitor. When the plates of the capacitor are maintained at constant charge, so clearly we are seeing this force is depend upon the length of the dielectric that is inserted between the plates. Here we are seeing x now. Whenever x changes, this force also changes. That's why the force acting on the dielectric slab now we can treat as constant. It is not constant. Then what we can say? So it is variable. Why it is variable? Since it is dependent upon x. As x changes, this value of f also changes. So finally we can conclude that nature of this force is variable. Nothing but whenever the dielectric slab now introducing between the plates, at that time the value of the electrostatic force on it also changes. Okay, this is the expression for this force. I hope this lecture understood by you well. In the next session, we'll meet with one more concept. Thank you for watching.